The first president in U.S. history to be impeached twice, now also a convicted felon. Donald Trump was found guilty on Thursday, U.S. time, in all 34 counts of falsifying business records in the first degree. This was to cover up a payment to adult film star Stormy Daniels in exchange for her silence about an extramarital affair before the 2016 presidential elections. New York District Attorney Alvin Bragg says the 12 jurors unanimously found Trump guilty on all charges after more than 2 days of closed-door deliberations.
While this defendant may be unlike any other in American history, we arrived at this trial and ultimately today at this verdict in the same manner as every other case that comes through the courtroom doors, by following the facts and the law and doing so without fear or favor.
The erstwhile U.S. leader has denied wrongdoings and is expected to appeal the verdict.
This was a rigged, disgraceful trial. The real verdict is going to be November 5th by the people, and they know what happened here.
A statement from the campaign of U.S. President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris says the court's decision shows no one is above the law. It calls Trump a threat to American democracy and urges voters to prevent him from returning to the White House this November. In Congress, U.S. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer of New York was concise yet clear in his reaction. He simply said, "The verdict speaks for itself." While the leader of the House Democrats, Brooklyn's Hakeem Jeffries, says, "America is a nation built upon the rule of law, and responsible leadership demands that the verdict be respected." Meanwhile, Filipino-Americans who have been following Trump's criminal trial also chimed in. Lawyer and activist George Conway says, "There's no substantial justification for not sending him to prison." Others also cheered the conviction on Trump.
"Today is the triumph of the rule of law. It is a triumph of justice, a triumph of democracy, a triumph of the jury system. Now, lock him up."
I mean, this is an eye-opener, hopefully, for those people who still want him elected as president. I can't stop thinking of what would be if Trump will be the president again, especially for Asian American.
For Enzo Manzano of the Filipino-American Democratic Club of New York, this verdict will make a big impact come the elections in November.
"Filipino voters will face a pivotal decision in November to stand against Trump's tyranny or uphold the rule of law. We will organize, mobilize, and be the decisive force at the polls to protect the values that brought us all here in the first place."
It's unfortunately going to be something that fires up their base. He already started doing it when he came out of the courtroom today by saying it was a rigged trial.
Judge Juan Marchand set Trump's sentencing on July 11. It will come just days before the July 15 Republican National Convention that is expected to formally nominate Trump for president for the third time. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.